My skin was formed from the most fertile earth. So fertile, even Adam would feel envious. My mother's kisses were the only seeds I needed to bloom the most everything. By the time I was 8, I was a forest most fairies could only dream to live in. However, prior to that year, I had never known ice or snow, so the first time a white friend called me a nigger, I waited to melt his tundra heart and flourish from the puddles I planned to reduce him to. But the thing that most people don't know about Antarctica is that despite it being a frozen landmass, it is a desert. And this was the first time I learned that nothing blossoms from hate, that permafrost can be just as lifeless as sand. And even though no 8-year-old should have to cut down their forest to become a cactus, only a cactus can survive in a desert or a country filled with deserts. And every 8-year-old should survive. And in this poem, the black boy survives. The black boy gets to grow up. In this poem, the black boy doesn't drop out of school, doesn't overdose, doesn't join a gang, doesn't get arrested, doesn't get shot, doesn't have depression. The black boy gets to grow up to become a man, but isn't forced to be one. In this poem, the black boy simply gets to be, but isn't stung by a bee. He is the bee, and I pollinate myself enough to bloom the most everything. The black boy becomes a rainforest, so lush and beautiful and alive and alive and alive. Thank y'all so much.